So Microsoft just recently released the Windows 11 24H2 update, as you can see from the official Windows 11 downloads page here. And in this video, I want to go ahead and see if the methods that we could use previously to update to Windows 11 on unsupported hardware can still be used on version 24H2. So just to show you what I'm working with here, if we go and have a look at the system specs of this PC, it is running Windows 11 at the moment, but it is an unsupported PC as it's a Core i5 third gen. And also if we do a search for system information and we have a look at the TPM and secure boot, you can see that secure boot is off, which is another requirement for Windows 11. And if we go back to the system page and we have a look at the BitLocker settings here, and we go to TPM administration, you can also see that the TPM cannot be found because this motherboard does not support a TPM. So the current version of Windows 11 that I have running here is version 23H2, and I installed that using my unattended WinStall onser files. But in this video, I'm going to check and see if we can upgrade from version 23H2 to 24H2 on this unsupported system. And the methods I'm going to be showing you in this video, I've covered on the channel before. And this is basically just a test to see if it's still working. And I'll link all of those relevant guides in the description down below for you as well. So let's start by downloading the Windows 11 ISO file from the official downloads page here. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm just going to select the Windows 11 multi-edition ISO file. And then we're going to have to select the product language. Now to get the correct product language that you currently have installed on your system or on the system that you want to upgrade to Windows 11 24H2, on my website here, I've got some instructions. And basically we need to go ahead and run any one of these commands in PowerShell. So I'm just going to go ahead and copy that. Then I'm going to open Windows PowerShell by right-clicking on the start button. And then I'm just going to right-click to paste that command. And if I press enter and run that, then we can see that the current language that I have installed on this computer is English United States. Now, there's also a second command that you can run, which is this command. So I'm just going to go ahead and copy that as well. And then just run that in PowerShell as well. And you can see it gives us some more information, but the default system UI language is English United States. The system locale is also English United States. But that means I'm going to need to select English United States. So for you, if you have any other English version like UK or Australia or Europe or wherever, chances are on this drop-down menu here, you're probably going to have to select English International. And this is very important because it's going to determine if you can keep all of your files and apps during the upgrade process. So you're going to see that option a little bit later on in this video, and then I'll just mention it again. But for now, I'm going to select English United States because that's what I have installed on this system, and then just click on confirm. And now we have this error saying that we can't download it because some users are banned from using the service, but that has to be an error. So I'm just going to go and try again, and we're just going to go through this process again. Just select the language once again as English United States, and now we've got the download link. So if the same thing happens to you, just refresh the page and try again. But I'm just going to click on 64-bit download, which is going to start downloading the ISO file, which is just a little bit over 5 gigs in size, and we're just going to wait for that to finish, but I'll obviously speed this up in the video. All right, so the ISO file's just finished downloading. I'm just going to open it in the downloads folder here. And the first method I'm going to be trying to bypass the Windows 11 requirements is to delete the appraiserres.dll file's contents and then see if that bypasses the requirements. So to do that, I'm just going to right-click on this ISO file and then click on Mount. Then just accept the security prompt so it can open the file, and then it's going to open it in a File Explorer window. So next, what I want to do here is just minimize these windows and then drag this to the side here. Because on the desktop here, I'm just going to create a new folder, and I'm just going to call this Windows 11 24H2, and then open that folder, and then I'm just going to drag it to the right side here so I can see both of these windows. And then I'm going to select all of these files that I have inside of the ISO file that's mounted, and then I'm just going to right-click and drag them over to this folder that I just created. And I'm just going to click on copy here so I can make a copy of all of those files, because there's a specific file that we have to edit inside of there. So the file's just finished copying here, and I'm just going to minimize the ISO file, and then we're going to work inside of this folder here. So we're going to have to go to the sources folder, and then inside of this, we're looking for a specific file, and that file is called appraiserres.dll. So it's important, don't use appraiser.dll. You have to use appraiserres.dll, and then you can select it, then right click on it, and then we're just going to select open with, and we're going to have to choose an app on the PC. Now, normally you would be able to select Notepad to open this file. I don't actually have the Windows 11 Notepad app installed, but I'm just going to open the run box by pressing Windows key and R, and then I'm just going to type notepad.exe and then click on OK, which is going to open the old Notepad on the system here. And I'm just going to go ahead and drag this file into Notepad, which will open it here. And this is basically what the file looks like. I'm just going to click inside of this window, press Ctrl and A, and then I'm going to press backspace to delete everything inside of the file. Then I'm just going to go to File and then Save. And it's going to save the appraiserres.dll file, and there won't be any data inside of it anymore. As you can see, it's now 0 bytes. What we can do now is navigate back to the Windows 11 24H2 folder, and then I'm going to run this setup.exe file. I'll just accept the user account control prompt, and then we can see if we can bypass the Windows 11 setup requirements. So this is the language to install, time and currency format. I'm just going to leave that on the default, then click on next. I'll leave the keyboard settings on the defaults as well. Click on next. It's going to do some checks on the system. It wants us to enter a product key, but we also have the option of choosing I don't have a product key. So I'm going to click on that. Then it prompts us for the version that we want to install. I want to install Windows 11 Pro. Then click on next. It's going to do some checks on our PC. And then it says that the PC doesn't meet the requirements to run Windows 11. Because the PC must support TPM 2.0. So that means deleting the appraiseries file does not work anymore. And I'm going to move on to another method. So I'm just going to click on close. And then what I'm also going to do is just delete this folder because we're not going to be using that anymore. So the next method I'm going to be trying is to use Rufus. So I'm going to download Rufus, which also bypasses the Windows 11 requirements, or it used to. So I'm just going to go ahead and download the standard version of Rufus, then show it in the downloads folder, and I'm just going to run that, accept the user account control prompt, and we can check for updates. Now, for this method, you will need a USB flash drive, or you'll need to create a virtual USB drive on your computer. And I basically show you how to do that in another video that I created on this channel. But for this video, I do have a SanDisk Cruiser Blade USB drive. So I've just plugged that in and it is detected in Rufus. So I'm going to go ahead and select the ISO file by clicking on the select button here. And then we downloaded it earlier. So it's saved in the downloads folder. So I'm just going to select that and click on open. I'm going to leave all of these other options on the default. We'll just change the name of the flash drive to Windows 11 24H2. And then I'm going to click on start. And now it's going to ask us if we want to remove the requirements that Windows 11 has. And I'm basically going to select all of these, except the one to create a local account with my username. But I'm going to have all of the others selected and then just click on OK. Then click on OK again, because it's going to format the USB flash drive. So all of the data that I had on it previously will be deleted. And then I'm just going to wait for this to finish creating the USB flash drive. So Rufus just finished creating this USB flash drive. So I'm just going to go ahead and close it. And then I'm going to navigate to this PC. And I'm just going to open the flash drive. This is the ISO file that I mounted earlier. So I'm just going to eject that. But this is the USB flash drive that I just created with Rufus, which is supposed to bypass the Windows 11 requirements. So I'm just going to run the setup again, and then we're going to see if we can bypass the requirements that way. I'm just going to click on this option here and select not right now, because I don't want to download any other updates. It's doing the checks on our PC, and this also blocks us from upgrading because the PC doesn't support TPM 2.0. And the processor also isn't supported for this version of Windows. So the Rufus method also does not work. The next thing I'm going to do here is to try and do a clean install of Windows 11 to see if that works. So I'm going to go ahead and restart the computer. Then I'm just going to press F12 so I can select the SanDisk USB flash drive as a boot option. And we're going to go ahead and boot from that. In the setup here, I'm just going to leave these language settings selected. Click on next, leave the keyboard settings selected as well. And then I'm going to install Windows 11. Then I also have to click on I agree that everything will be deleted, including my files, apps and settings. I'm just going to see if we don't have a way around that. And I'm going to go ahead and click on next. Click on I don't have a product key. It's doing the checks on our system. Then I'm going to select Windows 11 Pro. Click on next. It was doing some more checks and it skipped past that. But I'm just going to click on accept now to accept the license agreement. It's searching for disks. And now I can select the partition where I want to install Windows 11. So if I do it this way, it shouldn't be deleting my files. It will delete the apps, but it's going to keep all of the files that I had and put that in the windows.old folder. So I've got disk 0 partition 3, and this is the primary partition, and it also has 82 gigs of free space. So I'm going to leave that selected, then click on next. Then it says it's going to install Windows 11 Pro and it's going to keep nothing. So I'm guessing it won't keep my apps. And to keep the apps, maybe I had to select the repair my PC option, but I'm going to go ahead and install Windows 11 here because I don't really have any files on this computer. And this is just to test. So I'm going to go ahead and click on install and we're going to see if we've got Windows 11 24H2 running on this unsupported system when it's done. So it looks like it just finished installing. Let's go ahead and go through the onboarding experience here. I'm not going to name this PC. I'm just going to skip it for now. Then I'm going to set it up for personal use because I'll be able to create a local account, I think, because I selected that during the creation of the USB flash drive with Rufus. Now, it didn't actually allow me to create a local account, and I think it's because I'm connected to the internet. So I'm just going to disconnect the Ethernet cable real quick. And now that it's disconnected, I'm just going to restart the PC real quick. So I'm going to press Shift and F10, which will open the command prompt. I'm just going to type the following command, which is shutdown space forward slash R to restart the PC and then space forward slash T for time in seconds. And I'm just going to press 1, which means 1 second. Then I'm going to press enter and it's going to restart the PC. So just as I expected, after the restart and disconnection of the Ethernet cable, I now have this option that says I don't have internet. And if I click on that, it should allow me to create a local account. And yes, it does. So I'm just going to enter memory here and then click on next. I'm not going to create a password, so I'll just leave it blank and then click on next again. And then it should load into Windows 11 24H2 and take us directly to the desktop. All right, so we've just loaded into the desktop here, and I can see that Windows Spotlight is enabled by default. As you can see, I'm still not connected to the internet now. If I right-click on the Start button and we go to System, let's just confirm that we do have Windows 11 24H2 installed. And yes, as you can see, this is Windows 11 24H2 that I just installed. And it is on the same hardware that I showed at the start of this video, which is a Core i5 third gen. And also if you go to BitLocker and we look at TPM, you can see that there's still no TPM installed. And then also if I do a search for system information, I still don't have secure boot enabled. So you can still run Windows 11 24H2 on unsupported hardware, as I'm showing you in this video. And this was done with a clean install using a USB flash drive that was created with Rufus. Now there is still another option that I want to try to do the upgrade to version 24H2 and basically keep all of our files and apps. Now the last in-place upgrade method I want to try here is to use command prompt or PowerShell, and I'm still going to be using the USB flash drive that I created with Rufus. So if I open that, I can see that it's mounted to drive D. Now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to do a search for CMD. Now you'll be able to use command prompt or PowerShell or terminal, doesn't matter. But I'm just going to use the command prompt in this video and then run it as administrator. Just click on yes to allow that. Now what I'm going to do next is I'm just going to select the setup file, then right click on it. Then I'm going to select this option to copy as path. And you can also do that with Control Shift and C. But I'll just select that option here and then go back to the command prompt window. Then I'm just going to right click in this window And next, I just want to remove those quotes. So I'll just press backspace and then use the arrow key to go back and remove that quotation mark there. And then next to this, I'm going to type /product/server, then press enter. That should launch the setup executable file as it's doing now. And it should show that it's going to install Windows Server. So I'm just going to change the update options to not right now. Not that it really matters because I'm not connected to the internet anyways. But I just want to see if we can bypass the Windows 11 requirements check using this method. And it seems that it did bypass it. I'm just going to accept the license terms. Then we can choose what to keep. We can keep our files, settings, and apps. That's what I want to do. So I'll click on next. It's going to make sure if we're ready to install. It's making sure that the PC has enough space. And then we can go ahead and install Windows 11 Pro, because that's what I have installed on the system now. Although it says that it's the Windows Server setup screen here, it is still going to upgrade the current version of Windows 11 that you have installed, and it's keeping all of the files, settings, and apps, because the version of Windows that I'm using here, it's got the same language installed as the ISO file that I downloaded at the start of this video, which was English United States. So if I go ahead and click on install here, it should start upgrading to Windows 11 24H2. Now I know I already have Windows 11 24H2 installed on this machine, so I'm not going to go ahead and click on install now. Instead, what I'm going to do is I'm going to install Windows 10 on this computer and then try and upgrade from Windows 10 to Windows 11 using this exact method. Now, if you want to see how I upgrade from Windows 10 to Windows 11 24H2 using the method that I just showed you, you can go ahead and watch the next video on screen now, because I'm going to create a separate video for that guide. But I really hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a like, and I'll talk to you guys soon.